So syntax analyzers, production rules that are defined by the means of context-free grammars, the way the production rules are implemented, derivation divides parsing into two types. One is the bottom-up parsing, another is the top-down parsing. So under top-down parsing, when the parser that starts constructing the parse tree from the right symbol and then tries to transform the start symbol to the input, it is called the top-down parsing. And recursive descent parsing is that it is a common form of top-down parsing. It is called recursive as it uses the recursive producers to process the input. Recursive descent parsing suffers from backtracking. So what do we mean by backtracking? Backtracking means, it means that if one derivation of a production fails, the syntax analyzer starts the processing using different rules of same production. This technique may process the input stream more than once to determine the right production. So under top-down parsing, there is recursive descent. From recursive descent, there is backtracking, then non-backtracking. Under non-backtracking, there is predictive parser, then LL parser. So what is LL parser? LL parser accepts LL grammars. LL grammar is a subset of context-free grammars from automata, but with some restriction to get simplified version in order to achieve easy implementation. So LL grammars can be implemented by means of both algorithm, namely recursive descent or table-driven parsing. So what is LR parsing? LR parsing, under LR parsing, there are SLR parsing, then LR parsing, then LA LR parser is there. So what is LR parser? LR parser is non-recursive, shift-reduced bottom-up parser. It uses a wide class of context-free grammars, which makes it the most efficient syntax analysis technique. LR parser is also known as LR look-ahead parser, that is LRK. So where L stands for the left-to-right scanning to the input stream, and R stands for the construction of the rightmost derivation in recursive, and K stands for the number of the look-ahead symbols to make the decision. So there are three widely used algorithms available for constructing an LR parser. SLR1, that is simple LR parser, works on smallest class of grammar, few numbers of states, hence very small table, simple and fast construction. Another one is the LR1 parser that works on the complete set of LR1 grammar, generates large table and large number of the states, slow construction. And lastly, the LALR1, that is look-ahead LR parser, that works on the intermediate size of the grammar, number of the states are same as that of the SLR1, that is first one. So let us take one example, one SLR1 grammar. So from E, the production rules is capital B, capital B. From capital B, we are getting capital C, capital B and small d. So add augmented production and insert dot symbol in the first production for every production in capital G. That is the grammar given. So from E dash dot symbol capital E, from E capital E, we are getting dot symbol capital B, capital B. From capital B, from this one, we are getting dot symbol capital C, capital B. From capital B, we are getting dot symbol small d. So the I0 state, that is add starting production to the I0 state and then compute the closure. Since dot symbol is on the left side of the symbol, so therefore all the production beginning with capital E will be added in the I0 state, that is the initial state, because dot symbol is followed by the non-terminal. So nextly, the from I0 state E dash, then dot symbol capital E. From capital E, we are getting dot symbol, then capital B, capital B. So here we can see that dot symbol is on the left of the variable capital B. So all the productions beginning with capital B will be added in the initial state, I0 state, because dot symbol is followed by the non-terminal. So the final production that we are getting from the I0 state, that is the initial state, capital E dash, that is dot symbol capital E. From capital E, we are getting dot symbol capital B, capital B. From capital B, we are getting dot symbol capital C, capital B. And from capital B, we are getting dot symbol capital D. So from I1 state, that is the next state, next state, here we have applied go to on capital I0, capital E, that is the initial state and capital E, then closure of capital E dash to dot symbol capital E. So here the dot symbol is on the right hand side of the production rule. So I1 becomes capital E dash to capital E. So I2 will have applied go to on the I0 state of B, that is closure of capital E, capital B, capital B. So from I2 state, we have applied go to on I0 of capital B. So from capital B, we are getting capital capital E, we are getting capital B dot capital B. From I2, the final production that is that we are getting from I2 state, that is capital E, from capital E, capital B dot capital B. From capital B, we are getting dot symbol capital C, capital B. From capital B, we are getting dot symbol capital small d. So go to I2 of C, that is closure of capital B, capital C dot capital B, same as that of the I3 state, and go to on I2 of B, that is closure of capital B dot symbol small d, same as that of the I4 state. So from I3 state, go to on I0 of capital C, that is closure of capital B, small c dot capital B. So on the production that is starting from capital B in the I3 state. So these are the production that we are getting. So nextly, here comes the parsing table of this grammar. So first is that all the states are there up to I6, then action taken, then go to state. So from I0 state, capital 3, capital S3, capital S4. Yeah, from initial, we are getting small c, small d, dollar symbol, and the go to state is capital E, capital B. I1 state is accept state, that is go to state is 5. I2 is S3 and S4, action is taken, and then go to step is go to step is 6. From I3 step state, we are getting the action that we are getting capital S3, capital S4. Then from capital I4 state, we are getting R3, R3. Then I5, we are getting R1. Then I6, R2, R2, R2. So follow of B equals to first up of B, that is C and small d. Then follow of E equals to dollar symbol. Thank you, sir. Next slide will be discussed by my rest.
So if G is a grammar which start symbol is, then G, the argument grammar for G is the grammar with new start symbol is dash, and if production is dash equals to S dot. The purpose of this new starting production is to indicate to the parser when it should stop parsing and announce acceptance of input. Let a grammar to see. S equals to A, capital A, capital A. Then capital A, capital A goes to small a, capital A, such as B. The augmented grammar for the above grammar will be capital S dash equals to capital S, capital H dash, capital S equal to capital A, capital A, then capital A equals to small a, capital A, and B. Next is LR items, LR0 items. And LR0 item is the item of grammar G. Capital G is a production of capital G with a dot at some position in the right side. Capital S equals to capital A, capital B, capital C yields four items. Capital S equals to dot capital A, capital B, capital C. Capital S equals to capital A dot B, capital B, and capital C. And capital S equals to A, capital A, capital B dot capital C. A capital S equals to capital A, capital B, capital C dot. The production A, capital A equals to summation generates only, sorry, epsilon generates only the only one item, capital A equals to dot epsilon. Then closure operation. Closure operation, if I is a set of items for a grammar capital G, then closure is the set of items constructed from I by the two rules. First one is, initially every item in a capital I is added in closure. And the rule number two is, if capital A equals to alpha beta alpha dot b and beta is in closure, and capital B equals to gamma is a production, and then add the item capital B equals dot gamma to I. If it is not already here, we apply this rule until no more items can be added in closure. So this is the closure diagram. Capital S, capital S dash equals to capital S, capital S equals to capital A, capital A, and capital A equals to small a capital A by B. And closure S dash equals to capital S, and that goes to capital S dash equals to S, that S is a non-terminal, and so add in the S. So and capital S equals to dot capital A capital A, and A equals to dot capital dot small a capital A by dot B, and capital S equals to capital A dot capital A equals to capital S goes to capital A dot capital A, and capital A equals to small a capital A by dot B. And closer capital A equals to small a, and capital A dot equals to capital A equals to small a dot capital A. And this is the grammar. Grammar is A capital A equals to capital A plus capital A, and capital A equals to A minus capital A minus capital A, and A equals to A, and A equals to small a. Input string is A1 minus A2 plus A3. And the Pershing table is in, and this is the stack, and this is the stack up to dollar A, and this is the inputs, and this is the actions, and the configuration of shift reduce version of input is a small A1 equal minus A2 plus A3, and the next slide will be discussed by
parsers. So basically, bottom up parsing starts from the leaf nodes of a tree and works in upward direction till it reaches the root node. Here we start from a sentence and then apply production rules in reverse manner in order to reach the start symbol. So a general shift reduce parsing is LR parsing. The LR stands for scanning the input from left to right, and R stands for constructing a rightmost derivation in reverse. Benefit of LR parsing is many programming languages using some variation of LR parser, and secondly, LR parser can be implemented very efficiently. And lastly, of all parsers that scan their symbols from left to right, LR parser detect syntax errors as soon as possible. So now I am describing this grammar. So here capital S implies small d capital A slash small a capital B, and capital A implies small b capital A slash C. Capital B implies small b capital B slash C. And now augmented grammar is S dash implies dot S, S implies dot small d capital A slash dot small a capital B. And A implies small b capital A slash dot C, and capital B implies dot small b capital B slash dot C. Now the initial state is this, and S dash implies dot S, S capital S implies small d capital A, S implies dot small a capital B. So this is I0 state. And now the S implies to S, S dash implies S, this is I1 state, and S implies small d dot A, capital A implies small b dot A, and capital A implies capital C. So this is the I2 state. And capital state, capital S implies small a dot B, capital B implies dot small b capital B, and capital B implies dot small c, and this is the I3 state. So now I2 states shift operation are A implies to S implies small d capital A, this is the I4 state, and capital A implies small b dot capital A implies small b dot small b capital A, and A implies dot C. So this is the I5 state. And capital A implies C dot, and this is the I6 state. Now I3 state shift operation R, B capital B implies C, this is the capital S implies AB, this is the I7 state, and capital B implies B dot V, this capital B implies dot B capital B, and B implies capital B implies dot C, this is the I8 state, and capital B implies C, this is the I9 state. And I8 shift reduction, this is the shape loop from B, and capital B capital B implies small b capital one. This is the I-11 state. And now I'm describe the parsing table. So this is the Xn and GoTo, and there are 11 state. So Xn part of the table contains all the terminals of the grammar, whereas the GoTo part contains all the non-terminals. For every state of GoTo graph, we write all the GoTo operation in the table. If GoTo is applied to a terminal, then it is written in the Xn part. If GoTo is applied on a non-terminal, it is written in GoTo part. If on applying GoTo, a production is reduced, if the dot reaches at the end of the production and non further closure can be applied, then it is denoted as Ri, R, and if the production is not reduced, shifted, it is denoted at as S. If a production is reduced, it is written under the terminals given by follow the left side of the production which is released for I1 state, for 0 state S3, S2, 1, and I1 state is the acceptances, and I2 state S5, S3, 4, I3 state S8, S9, this is Xn, and GoTo is 4, I4 state, I5 state, Xn is S5, S6, and GoTo is 10, and I8 state, Xn is S8, S9, and GoTo is 11. And the next part described by the rest of the team members. Thank you, sir.
There are three production. S2 small I capital E small t capital S and capital S dash or A slash A. Second one is S capital S dash 2 small e capital S or F silent. Third one is capital E 2 small b. So this is the grammar here. I stands for if, E is for expression, T is for then, S is for statement, and E is for else. So solution of this grammar is the terminal symbol is the grammar are I, T, small I, small T, small A, small E, and small B. So here I see that first of I to get single tone I, and first of T we get single tone T, and first of A we get single tone A. Simultaneously we get first of E to single tone I, and first of B then we get single tone B, and first of F silent then we get single tone F silent. Here is the parsing table of the grammar. So you can see that here are three states, S, A, capital S, S dot, and E. So in the A section, in the A section, we get S to capital S to small a, and I section we get S to small I, capital E, small t, capital S, and capital S dash. And in the S dash section, we get S dash to F silent, and capital S dash to get small e. And in the dollar section, we get S dash to F silent. In third one, E section, we get capital E to B. So multiple entries, this is not a LL1 grammar. So if a grammar contains left factoring, then it cannot be LL1. Like example, S to A small a, capital S or A, both production go in A. If a grammar contains left recursion, it cannot be can be LL1. Like example, S to capital S to capital S and small a or B, small b. Second one is S to capital S a and small a goes to first of S to B, and third one is S to B goes to B. This B has two entries, hence not LL1 grammar. If a grammar is not ambiguous, then it cannot be LL1. Every regular grammar need not be LL1, because regular grammar may contain left factoring and left recursion or ambiguities. Here have some get level question. First one is this is the grammar. There are two production, S to capital S to capital C C and capital C to small c capital C or small d. So the answer is the grammar is LL1 grammar. The grammar type is LL1 grammar type. Second one is given the following expression grammar. Here are two production e to e into f capital F or f plus e or f, and second one is f to f minus f and or small I small d. So here the answer is minus has a higher precedence than. And here is the third one grammar. For the grammar, here we can see capital S to capital A capital B and or small capital C. Second one is capital A to small b capital A or small a, and third one is b to small a b small b and capital S or small b or capital S and or S silent. And so the fourth one is C capital C to small b and capital C or F silent. So the answer is follow is so answer is B. B is the answer. So what is the answer? A, B, dollar. The fourth one is in the context of abstract syntax tree and control flow graph, which of the following is true? So here C the max number of successor of a node is in a ACT and a CFG depends on the input. Here's the answer. Our fifth one is which of the following is true and any valid state in C produce parsing. So C is the answer. Stack contains only variable prefixes.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.